Yeah, well, my name is Hunter Milbourne. I was the founder of Milbourne Real Estate in 1976. And at that point, the condominium market really consisted of four developments compared to today, where there's around 325 to 350 condominium projects on the market in the GTA. You know, people in the market today would be interested to know that the price per square foot of the mid-market ones were $60, and the price per foot of the high-end ones at that time were $100 a square foot.
Hunter, at Condo Outlet, we get a lot of leads every day from our website asking about different projects. Tell us some of the projects that you've been involved in recently and what's been happening locally.
Well, in the GTA today, there's approximately 325 to 340 projects on the market at any one given time. There's some opening, some closing. We have about 40 projects that are our listings. We have about 10% of the projects and just under about 20% of the sales. So we've got probably a concentration of new projects downtown. Some of the more recent ones that we've launched, we've launched the conversion of the old Four Seasons Hotel building into 511 residential condominiums that has sold quite well. It's about 60% sold in the first 6 weeks. One was recently launched at Bathurst and Bloor, about 200 suites called B Streets. And it's done very, very well too in the first couple of months. It's about half sold. One called The Bond, which is at John and Adelaide. It's a tower, about 40 stories, about 400 units. It's also done very well. So I think that in the market today, if there's a great location, good sponsorship with the developers, and appropriately sized and priced units, then there's great absorption.
Hunter, why do you think that over 25,000 condos were sold this year in Toronto? What makes Toronto so special among all the cities in the world? What's happening here? What is really going on?
There's a number of reasons, but one reason is immigration, in-migration to Toronto. I mean, Toronto is a growing city. It's one of the fastest growing cities in the world. It gets a lot of domestic immigration. If you're a young person living in a smaller town in the neighboring province of Ontario or anywhere else, I mean, you know, the jobs are in the city, the fun is in the city, so chances are you're going to migrate to the city. Canada as a country gets approximately 260 to 280,000 net new foreign immigrants every year. And a large percentage of them are going to the cities, Vancouver, Toronto, Montreal, a lot to Toronto. So that net in-migration, which isn't a recent phenomenon, that's been the case for the last 30-odd years, it's required that the city of Toronto in the GTA has required about 40 to 45,000 new housing units per year to basically accommodate that net in-migration. You know, when we started in the mid-70s, most of that new housing product came from low-rise townhomes and single-family. And virtually every year up until 2007 was kind of the year where there were actually more high-rise condominium sales than low-rise sales. So that was a turning point in the industry. And I think with the Greenbelt legislation that came in 2005, with infrastructure capacity issues in the suburban 905 region with roads and sewer capacities, and a bit of a lessening demand because people with gas prices and increasing commuting times, you know, the demand has shifted down to the core and to the subway type nodes, away from the more extreme, you know, outlying locations. And the supply has been constricted too because of the Greenbelt and these capacity issues.
Hunter, at Condo Outlet, we get asked every day, investors come into our retail stores, they say, should I buy new construction or should I buy an existing condo? What would you recommend to an investor?
Well, you know, it's an interesting point. There's always a spread between the price of resale and the price of new because you're typically looking at a 3 to 4 to 5 year time frame. So most investors have purchased new simply because there's a little more leverage at play, because if you're putting up a 15 or 20% deposit over a year and that market's going up even at a modest 3 or 4% a year, then by the time your delivery closes in 3 or 4 or 5 years, you've got a nice return on your asset, but a very good return on your equity with that compounded annual rate of appreciation. Plus, if you're purchasing an existing condominium, it needs to be financed, it needs to be closed, it needs to be rented, it needs to be managed, so it's a little more time intensive. The pre-sale purchase is a little more trouble-free. And because the historical rate of appreciation has been there, that's where most investors are tending to purchase. On the contrary, I mean, most users don't want to purchase a pre-sale because when they're motivated to buy a condominium, they don't want to wait 4 years. So they're typically, you know, buying an existing product and maybe upgrading a bathroom or kitchen or hopefully finding something that would work for them as is.
Hunter, you know, we're so excited about sponsoring the GTA Property Show. Why do you think it's so important for people to come to the GTA Condo Expo?
You know, I think for any person who's thinking of purchasing a condominium, you know, everyone's an investor because the investor's an investor, but the user is an investor too because otherwise they might as well rent. They want to buy something that's going to be intelligent and go up in value. So I think the opportunity to come to a show like the condominium show in early November is a great thing because you get a whole bunch of experts concentrated in a room for 2 days, and it's like a mini mentorship program. You know, you get the chance to go to seminars, talk to people in their booths, just mingle and mix with other people of like minds. And I think it's a, you know, when I started out in my career, I mean, the whole goal is to learn as much as you can. That's how you become an expert at something, is you try and learn. So I think it's a great opportunity for people to come and basically get a very concentrated dose of information that they can apply in their practical purchases. So I look forward to meeting everyone that's watching at the Hyatt Hotel at King and Blue Jay Way on Saturday, November 5th.